My first lessons in light were under the cover of darkness. From bardic lamplit country roads to safe light enclosed, the darkroom in Irish Street was like a lookout post. My da, a memory-making middleman, assessor from the Ministry of Lost Causes, taking sides under cover of darkness, an after-mathematician. Shutter speeds, paying heed as they transform ecstatic spark into tracer-like ribbons on a stick, all skite and bow, flitting away aimlessly as they hurled buckets of water on the bastard flames of history. You hold in your hand the remnants of a covenant, a bellicose, blunderbussing scattergun of a man. Carson's bar set high. Was he really fit to outwit Wilde? Easter 1974. Not everyone's playing hide the egg. I'm sucked into their only visible weapon, their uber presence. Erect, like sundials gathering darkness, they are clocked to 10. Your jacked up valance brow, furrowed at high noon, hung like drawn back drapes, vainly shadowing overexposed eyes. Eyes now occupied by what the dead left behind. This burden of perpetual inspection makes yours a hyper-presence, as you envelop a hurt with words, as you might an undead parent in a dream. One last time. You're wording the gold in the glue, the bright sun on our mongrel tongue. Here stands a father saluting the soldier and his daughter. All 17 years of her. 16 Christmases. The unthinkable has stopped with him, and such doors don't get unknocked, undarkened. Cop's gate crashing a period drama. Three buckets betray her predilection. If not for the smiles, it could be the famine. Headline, the falter caught mid-eviction.